Hi, I'm Dr. Nicole Vane of Moonlight Beach Dental, a holistic and integrative biologic dental practice. And one topic that's been coming up a lot lately is, are there any alternatives to the metal or titanium implants? A lot of people have a lot of concerns about metals, and especially metals that are being integrated into their bone, like really into their body. So are there any alternatives? Now, zirconia implants have been on the market for more than 10 years. The problem with the zirconia implants is that they were very limited by distribution and also in the number of parts that were available for the surgeon. And some of this created a not great result in the regard that some people need really specific lengths of the implant and parts that go with it to have an implant be properly restored. Now, a properly restored implant is 94% successful long-term. So it's really worth the investment if you have the right surgeon and the right materials and the right parts. So let's go into what an implant is. Very quickly, essentially, into the implant socket, whether the tooth's been missing for 30 years or it was just pulled, they place a metal post. Essentially, it's shaped like a little screw. It's threaded into the bone. And around those screw threads, the bone fills in. It's called osteointegration. And then, once it's solid in the bone, we put some parts in above the gum line. That's called the abutment and the crown. And that's screwed in. And then it feels like you have a real tooth in there. The tissue adapts around it and it feels very normal. Now, what an implant looks like is this. So here's this little post that goes into the bone, and then we have a crown emerging from it. We have some really, really cool techniques on how to do the ceramic and ceramic parts that go above the gum line. But again, the past decade or more, there haven't been alternatives for this titanium part that goes into the bone. So we do have some pamphlets, if you ever come into the office, on zirconia implants and what the types and pieces are. And long term, there's not as many studies on how long they last, because we found that a lot of them were failing just because initially they were coming only in one long piece. So essentially, it was sometimes a square going into a round hole. It was the wrong piece in the wrong situation. Does that mean zirconia implants are bad? Absolutely not. But that's why a lot of surgeons aren't well versed in how to place them. I work very specifically with one surgeon who has researched and found many options. So now some of these stumbling blocks that we had with finding the right parts and pieces, he is very comfortable with restoring them and placing them. And by an appointment with me and then a consult with him, we'll figure out what the best option is for you and for your long-term success of your implant.